Susan Mercer from Illinois writes, because of my job, I only get 5 to 6 hours of sleep. I use lots of coffee to wake up. Then I have trouble at the end of the day going to sleep. What can I do? Help! What's so important about sleep, Dr. Horner?
You know, sleep is considered one of the pillars of health in Ayurveda. And that's because it is crucially important to our health. You may think, you know, why do I have to do that? I used to think that. Gosh, I could wish I could work all night, you know. But what happens is that it's a time actually for our body to rest and repair itself. So there's a lot of things that are happening during the night where your cells are kind of detoxifying and everything's kind of getting reset and repaired. And there's a lot of different hormonal fluctuations that occur throughout the day and throughout the night. And so getting enough sleep, the right hours, the right time is crucial for getting the best hormonal levels.
Well, wait a minute. Thomas Edison only got 4 or 5 hours of sleep a night, and he seemed to do okay for himself. I mean, what's wrong with
there's some rare people that do that.
Why doesn't Susan just get 5 or 6?
Because what the research shows is that the optimal number of hours that you should get is between 7 and 8 hours. If you sleep less than 6 hours a night, you actually have a much higher incidence of heart disease, diabetes, cancers, and so forth. And the same thing if you sleep too many hours at night too. So greater than 9 hours a night is something that's increased level of disease.
But she uses coffee to try to get herself awake and maybe uses it throughout the day. We're downing gallons of soda pop
right.
that has caffeine
uh-huh.
in it. Isn't this going to be a problem for us if we're constantly stimulating our bodies
Absolutely.
To then wind down at
right.
the end of the day?
Right, yeah. And you know what's really interesting? So Ayurveda, which is a traditional system of medicine from India, is 5,000 years old. And it actually told us 5,000 years ago that we should go to bed by 10 o'clock and get up by 6 o'clock. And so what modern research shows is this is exactly the number of hours that we should sleep and the best times for us to sleep. So we have a sleep hormone called melatonin. So when it starts to get dark at night, what happens is our melatonin levels start to rise. And if you go to bed by 10 o'clock, there is a peak in our melatonin levels between midnight and 2 a.m., which you don't want to miss because if you do, the consequences are absolutely spectacular.
But wait a minute, the creature features I watch start at 11 and they take me till 1. I mean, what?
This isn't good for you. So what I'm saying is that if you go to bed at that time, what happens is all these different hormonal fluctuations are optimal. So melatonin is not just our sleep hormone, but it also is a very powerful antioxidant. It regulates many of our different hormones, including estrogen, and it also stimulates our immune system. Now, there's so many different hormones that are interacting with each other that they found that if you actually stay up until midnight on a consistent basis, you have twice the incidence of diabetes, heart disease, and obesity. Even if you're eating the same number of calories, you may not be able to lose it because of that.
How about the coffee stimulant? Is that a bad thing, or can we tell Susan that she can keep, you know, downing coffee?
Well, here's the deal. If you actually go to bed by 10 and get up by 6, because that's another key thing too, is if you get up before 6 o'clock, you feel so refreshed and you have so much more energy that you're not going to need all those stimulants and all the depressants.
Okay, you mentioned melatonin. Are there other herbal supplements you recommend?
Sure. So melatonin is something that we produce naturally, and you know the best way to do it is to go to bed by 10 o'clock and have a really dark room because melatonin is very sensitive to light. But you can take melatonin supplements. So that's a really great thing to take because it works in harmony with our body and does not give us any kind of hangover. There are other kind of sleep aids that you can take that are mild and they just help to kind of settle down your nervous system, such as chamomile, valerian, kava kava. These are all herbs that settle our nervous system and help prepare us for sleep.
Great. Well, thank you so much for sharing your views on how to manage sleep.
I'm going to mention one other thing, though.
Okay.
You know what? There's certain things with your lifestyle. So if you exercise like late at night, it stimulates you too much. So there's certain times of the day that are the best times for doing certain activities that can have an influence. So exercise in the morning is considered best. If you exercise late at night, it'll keep you up. If you eat your main meal at noon, that's ideal. If you eat too late at night, you're digesting and you can't really sleep. And then you also want to do activities that kind of soothe your body, so you're going to be reading or listening to pleasant music. You're not going to be watching, you know, hacker movies and horror films that are going to keep you up. So all of those things are going to help.
Great. Well, there's good news for Susan and for the rest of us. Thank you again. If you have a question about this topic or any other, please just click on the link below. We'd love to hear from you.